anyone who desires to be useful in the service of God will soon realize that he has a major problem. And contrary to the popular opinion, that major problem is not the devil, but self, the flesh. The average believer is at the center of this battle. To serve God wholeheartedly, or to serve absolutely, or to manage both. Sometimes he finds himself torn apart in the midst of this battle. Mere man-made principles do not help. Self can even go quiet for a while, and it will seem as though it has been conquered, only to resurface after a while and cause great havoc. Even the great apostle had to cry out at some point over the wretchedness of his flesh and his human helplessness in the face of it. Romans chapter 7, verse 18 to 24. So this is a major problem, and the cure is not found in many more spiritual exercises. No. It is possible to still fall into immorality after a lengthy period of fasting. More activities has never cured the self problem. The solution is potent yet unattractive, powerful yet despised, simple yet unbelievable, beautiful yet bloodstained, an emblem of glory yet mistaken for just suffering and shame. And after running round the cycle, you will still find that herein lies the solution of self. And the solution is the cross. As Watchman Neal rightly puts it, the flesh is too bad to be cleansed. It must be crucified. Until we crucify the flesh with all its passions, we may keep failing and falling despite many methodologies. Our methods and all we learned about it might not help us. The only thing we require to overcome the flesh is the cross. And for all the people who desires that God should help them, to should use them in this season, it is my sole desire, it is my advice for all of us, that we should crucify ourselves. The Bible says, I have been crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live. The life I live now is no longer mine, but the life of the Son of God that is at work in me. That was when he was liberated, he was delivered, he was set free. That became his confession. If we must go thus far, the same must become our confession. Can we accept Jesus totally, run to him and crucify the flesh and turn our back totally upon the old man and be saved? May the Lord show us mercy. In Jesus' name, amen.